this is Dave with EdgeStar Technical Support. Here today we have the ICM301SS. This is our countertop ice cream maker. I'm going to show you basic operation and setup instructions. All right, this is the ICM301 stainless steel ice cream maker. It's our portable countertop model. This is brand new for us. We're excited to have it. First thing I want to do is I want to show you what comes in the box, and then we'll talk a little bit about setting up the unit and cleaning and things like that. So the first thing I'm going to show you is what comes in the box. And there's several things. First thing we have here is, of course, your ubiquitous ice cream scoop, as you can see. And the nice thing about this one has a little eject here, so you can just hit the button and it'll help you eject the ice cream out of the bowl of the scoop there. Of course, we have our manual. Now, on the top of the unit, you'll find a stir motor, and this is our stir motor. It's got a fan in here. You want to make sure that you don't obstruct any of these ports, any of these openings at all. You don't want to cover these up at all. A couple of things of note on the motor. Here we have all of our electrical connections. They all plug into the top up here. And then, of course, we have our motor extension here for the stir pedal. So it's pretty light. It's pretty compact. But just be mind, don't get this wet. And don't short any of these terminals, and make sure you keep everything in here clean. The next thing we have is our guard assembly, and this actually locks into place. There's an icon on the side for lock and unlock, and you'll feel it do that when you turn it. What we're going to do is turn it about an eighth of a turn towards the right. That'll unlock the guard here. This is your guard. Now, over here you may ask what this is, and what this is for adding solids, chocolate chips, M&M candies, things like that into your ice cream mix once it's started. This, of course, is your center hole, and this is your holder for your pedal. This all has to line up, folks. So once you get this in there correctly, and by the way, here's the tabs on the side, the locking tabs that we were talking about. So everything in here has to be lined up on the center spindle. I'll pick up the unit and give you a good overview once I get through all the components here. So again, this is your guard. This is your little cap here is held on by a chain. Just be careful you don't break the chain. This is our stir pedal that comes with the unit. It's open at both ends. Now your motor fits down in this slot. As you can see, it's shaped the same as the motor spindle. Down here on the other end, it's sort of rounded, and this fits a projection that's in the bucket. I'll show you that in a moment. And this, it's self-centering, so once you get everything lined up, it'll turn in there all by itself with no problem. The last thing in the ice cream maker is our actual bucket. This bucket has a couple of different functions, and I promised you I'd show you that center projection. It's right in the middle there. So our spindle, and I'll show you how that works, our spindle sits right in the middle, just like that. And then it turns here in the center. This bucket has a couple of dual functions. Number one, you actually make the mix in this bucket, but you can also store your ice cream in this bucket when you're done. You can just cover it with some plastic wrap, whatever you might have, aluminum foil, and it'll keep quite nicely in the deep freezer. So basic assembly on this thing is really easy. You're gonna wash everything with hot soapy water. You want to make sure everything is clean. So your guard, your stir pedal, your bucket, you're going to wash everything with hot soapy water and dry it and rinse it really well. And then you're going to insert your bucket right here into the top of the unit. Just like so. And it sits in there just like that. So the next thing we're going to do, now that we've got our bucket in there, is we're going to drop our stir pedal in there. So we're going to set that in here. And remember, the longer end of it actually is the part that faces up. So we're going to insert that in there, and we're going to kind of center that in there. I'm going to take my guard, and you might need to put this little cap on there just so it doesn't go flopping around. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to center my guard over the top edge of that spindle, and I'm going to drop it down. You'll feel it when it lines up and it drops in place, you know you've got it. So now I'm going to turn this to the left a little bit, and I felt it lock. So you have a definite detent there when it locks up. And then once you're done, you're going to drop your motor in here. you may find that your spindle is a little off and the motor won't drop down in there. You can actually either turn this motor shaft, it's pretty easy to turn, I'm turning it now, to line it up, or you can move the stir pedal, whichever you prefer. And one other thing here while I'm at it. Where the receptacle is, where your motor drops in, make sure you don't stick anything in there because those are live, that's 120 volts. If you stick anything in there, it will shock you. Make sure you try and keep that area dry. Don't get any liquid in there either. So once you've got everything assembled, your ice cream mix is in the bucket. Gonna drop our stir motor down and that locks it in place. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about the control panel. I'm just gonna go over that really quickly with you. All right, folks, I'm gonna talk a little bit here about the ice cream making process. Now, the book gives you some really good recipes. Of course, you can use any one that you want, if it's whether it's in the book or not. The important thing to remember is that the recipes in the owner's manual are portioned for the bucket size. So any other recipes that you use that aren't in the owner's manual, you need to cut them down to make sure that they fit in the bucket, because obviously we're going to have liquid in the bucket to start with, but as that freezes, it's going to expand. So you want to make sure that you keep a roughly about the same amount of liquid as they do in the recipes in the book. So let's assume for a moment that we have our mix in here. We're ready to operate this unit. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to cover the control panel really quick and then I'll show you how it works. Up here, I'm going to start at the top. We've got two lights. One says cooling, one says mixing. So initially what we're going to see is we're going to see our cooling light come on for the compressor. That tells us the cooling process has begun. And of course we'll have our light for our mixing. Now the LED here is our timer display. And over here we have our power button, start and stop, and our timer button. Now, you can actually monitor the temperature inside the bucket. When you hit that start button, when it starts the process, it will occasionally flash the temperature inside the bucket as well as your remainder of time that's left for the ice cream making cycle. Now, the timer button here at the bottom, you're going to want to run this thing about 30 minutes. It starts at 60 minutes, but you're going to want to run it down to about 30 minutes. And after that, you can bump that timer button and it will bump it up in 5-minute increments to basically whatever you want. So 35, 40, 45, and so on. You really can't do much less than 60 minutes. If you hit the timer button to start with, you can bump it down to 50 minutes. The next press will get you 55, and then we're back at 60 again. So ostensibly, you can only cut it back to about 50 minutes per cycle. So I'm going to go ahead and start it up. I've got my mix in here and I'm ready to go. So the first thing we're going to see is our display come up. It says 60 minutes. And I'm going to hit our start button. Now as you can see, we have a red light and a green light here for cooling and mixing, and our display is lit. And every so many seconds you'll see the temperature in the bucket, and that will change as it cools off. So as I was saying earlier, you can change your time here. We started out at 60. But you can change it here a little bit within reason to begin with, but you really want to wait until your ice cream starts to solidify a little bit. And that's also when you can actually put in your goodies here with that opening in the guard that I was telling you about earlier. So you want to wait till your ice cream starts to get a little bit hard, and then you can add all of your ingredients, your M&Ms, your chocolate chips, your peanut butter chips, whatever you're going to use. So bear in mind also that when the ice cream becomes thick and it's frozen really good, the motor here, you really don't want to stop it unless you can avoid it. Because if you do, you're probably not going to get that motor to restart. It doesn't have enough torque to turn against that hard ice cream. So if it's already running, you want to kind of leave it that way. You're looking at roughly about 60 minutes of runtime here with the entire ice cream making cycle as a general rule. I hope that this do-it-yourself video has helped you to set up and maintain your new ice cream maker, the ICM301SS. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact EdStar at www.edstar.com.